Hi, welcome to the first episode of a brand new series, History in 7 Facts. I am excited to finally launch this new series that's been in the works for quite a few months now. History in 7 Facts is a show in which we'll explore some of the most interesting things we know or not know about our own past. In the first chapter, we'll explore some of the things we know about the origins of human beings. So, shall we begin? Where do we come from? How did we end up on this planet? Where do we fit in the grand puzzle of life on Earth? These are questions that have been troubling us ever since we were able to ask them. There have been many theories throughout history about the origins of man and its role on this planet, and almost all of them involved the supernatural. Until, that is, Charles Darwin came up with a brand new idea, evolution. But when he published his book, On the Origin of Species, in 1859, he was ridiculed and dismissed by pretty much everyone. The idea that humans evolved from monkeys was preposterous, ridiculous, blasphemous even. However, in his book, Charles Darwin never actually said that humans have evolved from monkeys. In fact, he did not mention anything specific about human evolution. His book and his idea, however, became very famous, and once it traveled from mouth to mouth and filtered down, the idea of evolution was simplified down to this one statement, that humans are the descendants of monkeys. When talking about human origins, this image comes to mind to pretty much everyone. It sums up everything you need to know about the relationship between modern man and primates. Except, it's incorrect. Contrary to popular belief, humans are not the descendants of chimpanzees or gorillas or any other living primates. Instead, they're more like our modern cousins. We all have a common ancestor, one species from which all the others gradually evolved. Man's earliest ancestor was already walking on 2 feet 7 million years ago. And in the meantime, other groups were busy with perfecting a different kind of walking, on all four members, with emphasis on holding onto and jumping from branch to branch. So as I said, this picture is wrong. There is in fact no direct link between humans and other modern primates. We didn't evolve from them, and they didn't evolve from us. We are similar, yes, and we have a common ancestor from which our many species formed. But that's it. Instead, our evolution looks more like this. Some isolated groups of primates that could already stand and walk on 2 feet, just like modern chimps, simply had to do more walking in order to just survive. As the generations passed, those individuals that were capable of walking easier and for a longer time had a much greater chance of surviving and having offsprings. Thus, our lineage was born, a separate species that was getting increasingly better at walking for large distances out of necessity, not curiosity. Another great misconception is that we are the descendants of the much less intelligent Neanderthals. Wrong. First of all, Neanderthals were not stupid. Their brains were actually bigger than ours, and in fact, there is evidence to suggest that they actually taught Homo sapiens, that's us, how to use different tools. Second, we didn't evolve from them. We were just very, very close relatives with a relatively recent common ancestor. So why did they go extinct, while we, with our smaller brains, survived and thrived? Well, there is no exact answer to this, but it was probably a combination of these factors. Neanderthals were not as social as we are. They lived in small family groups of just a few individuals, while we lived in larger groups, forming villages and tribes, thus enabling us to diversify and cope with any external threats. Living in smaller groups meant that they had to travel a long way to meet others of their kind, to mate or cooperate, and with an ice age in the background, that surely didn't up their survival rate. They were also hunted. There is strong evidence to suggest that, at least occasionally, modern humans hunted and consumed Neanderthals like animals. Now, this wasn't a widespread practice, but it could have influenced the downfall of the species. But at least in some way, Neanderthals didn't actually go extinct, because they were absorbed in the human lineage, since there was a lot of interbreeding for a very long time. And since we humans had the greater numbers, we came out on top. In fact, today up to 2.1% of the DNA in humans outside of Africa is Neanderthal DNA. So why did our early ancestors become bipedal? To put it simply, it was out of necessity. 35 million years ago, the common ancestors of different primates were still roaming the tropical forests of our world. Most of these primates looked something like lemurs or tarsiers. By the way, lemurs, tarsiers, baboons, chimps, gorillas, monkeys, and humans are all one big primate family. Now, about 5 to 10 million years ago, temperatures started to drop around the world, which transformed lots of tropical forests into savannas. What was left of these forests was populated by what would eventually become monkeys, but some anthropoids or human-like primates started to adapt to this new environment. Gradually, these primates transformed. They had to stand up in order to keep an eye out on these wide open fields. Plus, they had to walk great distances to gather and protect their food. They also had to keep an eye out for predators. Since there were no trees around, there was no place for them to hide. The only chance they had was to spot the predator in time. This behavior is at least partly the reason why we've learned to cooperate, protect each other, become fiercely protective of our own family and tribe, have the urge to wage wars, but also being curious to see what's over the next hill. Tumai is one of the oldest fossils we have of a bipedal primate from 7 million years ago. Tumai looked more like a chimp than a man, but he was already walking on 2 feet rather than 4, which freed his soon-to-be hands to gather supplies. Plus, walking on 2 feet meant less energy spent on getting around. Studying fossils is a great way to find out more about our past, but what if I told you that you can walk in the actual footsteps of a long-lost couple of humanoids? Yes, it's true. You can see the actual footprints of a couple of Australopithecus in Laetoli, Tanzania. The footprints were made 3.6 million years ago by a male and a female and possibly a child who was playing by stepping into its parents' footsteps. What's really neat about this is that the footprints look very much like our own. Humans walk in a very distinct way. The weight is first distributed through the bases of the feet and then the fingers, while other primates that can walk on 2 feet swing while doing it and their soles are rotating. The footprints at Laetoli look distinctly human-like. It does make you wonder, what were those humanoids thinking about? Could they even think? And where were they going? So what is the full picture? Starting from around 9 to 10 million years ago, primitive anthropoids were still capable of living in trees, eating insects and fruits, but they had to walk increasingly larger distances through savannas to find new sources of food. 4 million years ago, bipedal walking was still awkward and quite hard, as the pelvis and the hips were not fully adapted to this type of getting around. 3 million years ago, our legs were longer and the hip got rounded, which made walking much easier. 2 million years ago, the basic skeleton of modern man was already developed and was, for the most part, almost identical to ours. As early as 400,000 years ago, the first humans of our kind were already roaming the Earth, and they were a lot stronger and muscular than we are today. And around 50,000 years ago, modern humans with distinct cultures, tools, and weapons lost a part of that muscle strength in favor of agility, planning, and cooperation. Thank you for watching this episode of 7 Facts. I hope this was interesting and informative, and maybe it even inspired you to look into it further on your own. If you like this video, please thumbs up and subscribe. While you're downstairs, let me know what you think about this video. Please consider visiting my Patreon page and become a patron. The link is in the description. I hope to see you next time. Bye.